Tyrannosaurus Rex, possibly the largest land predator that has ever lived.
T-Rex is sort of the quintessential monster.
A dinosaur with an attitude.
A Tyrannosaurus Rex can grow to 18 feet tall and over 40 feet long, with jaws designed to tear meat to shreds. This beast's reputation for violence and terror is unmatched.
That our observation has a direct effect on our world. I think if we keep it very simple, then people can get about the business of beginning to practice the skill of observation. See, the subatomic world responds to our observation, but the average person loses their attention span every 6 to 10 seconds per minute. So that doesn't leave a lot of room for our attention span. So how can the very large respond to someone who doesn't have the ability to even focus and concentrate? Maybe we're just poor observers. Maybe we haven't mastered the skill of observation, and maybe it is a skill. And maybe we're so addicted to the external world and so addicted to the stimulus and response to the external world that the brain is beginning to work out of response instead of out of creation.
So essentially, La ilaha illallah means that you accept there is one God, one creator of the heavens and the earth. God is not like anything in this universe, and nothing in this universe is like God. And we worship God alone. And we try to make our life and our religion sincerely and purely for Allah, the creator of the heavens and the earth. And that's very, very simply and short what La ilaha illallah means.
T-Rex had a sense of smell equivalent to 100 bloodhounds all duct-taped together.
The male is on the trail of a meal. A Tyrannosaurus Rex can pinpoint the exact location of an owner. Soon, he's headed straight for the dead Triceratops.
Things are bad, worse than bad. They're crazy. It's like everything everywhere is going crazy, so we don't go out anymore. We sit in the house, and slowly the world we're living in is getting smaller, and all we say is, please, at least leave us alone in our living rooms. Let me have my toaster and my TV and my steel-belted radios, and I won't say anything. Just leave us alone. Well, I'm not going to leave you alone. I want you to get mad.
إنني أنا الله لا إله إلا أنا فاعبدني فاعبدني وأقم الصلاة لذكري
وقل الحمد لله الذي لم يتخذ ولدا ولم يكن له شريك في الملك ولم يكن له ولي من الذل وكبره تكبيرا
وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون.
The bottom line is that the government is getting what they have ordered. They do not want your children to be educated. They do not want you to think too much. That is why our country and our world has become so proliferated with entertainments, mass media, television shows, amusement parks, drugs, alcohol, and every kind of entertainment to keep the human mind entertained so that you don't get in the way of important people by doing too much thinking. You had better wake up and understand that there are people who are guiding your life and you don't even know it.
Television, it is the most powerful weapon of psychological warfare in history. The programming that we are constantly assaulted by throughout our lives conditions us, it programs us to a particular worldview. Now, we may consider it normal because we were born into this system of lies and deception. And because we were born into this situation and our parents were born into it and have suffered from it, we don't know any better.
They don't want a population of citizens capable of critical thinking. They don't want well-informed, well-educated people capable of critical thinking. They're not interested in that.
اقرأ باسم ربك الذي خلق خلق الإنسان من علق اقرأ وربك الأكرم الذي علم بالقلم علم الإنسان ما لم يعلم.
يتبعون الرسول النبي الأمي الذي يجدونه مكتوبا عندهم في التوراة والإنجيل Thank you.
وما أرسلناك إلا كافة للناس بشيرا ونذيرا ولكن أكثر الناس لا يعلمون.
أوحينا إليك كما أوحينا إلى نوح والنبيين من بعده وأوحينا إلى إبراهيم وإسماعيل وإسحاق ويعقوب والأسباط وعيسى وأيوب ويونس وهارون وسليمان وآتينا داود زبورا ورسلا قد قصصناهم عليك من قبل ورسلا لم نقصصهم عليك وكلم الله موسى تكليما وبكفرهم وقولهم على مريم بهتانا عظيما وقولهم إنا قتلنا المسيح عيسى ابن مريم رسول الله وما قتلوه وما صلبوه ولكن شبه لهم وإن الذين اختلفوا فيه لفي شك منه ما لهم به من علم إلا اتباع الظن وما قتلوه يقينا بل رفعه الله إليه وكان الله عزيزا حكيما.
None of the people of the scripture, or Jews and Christians, are exempted from believing in Jesus before he dies, for after descending on his second coming, he will correct the distortions and false beliefs heaped upon him as lies. 2,000 years ago, the Jews rejected Jesus or Isa, the son of Mary, as their Messiah and plotted to have him killed, but Allah lifted Jesus to the heavens, whilst a substitute died on the cross in his place for prophecy to be fulfilled. Mary and 12 of his closest disciples were the last ones to see Jesus alive as eyewitnesses to his ascension as proof. Aged 33, he was put in a sleep-like stasis, not in need of nourishment, and 2 angels lifted him up through the roof. He threw his hood on Sha'mun, or Simon, possibly the disciple who volunteered to be transformed to take Jesus' place, and he was lifted to the second sky while his beloved mother waved him farewell with tears streaming down her face. Mistaken for Jesus, the brave substitute was arrested, humiliated with a crown of thorns, beaten and crucified. All who believed this were killed as heretics by Nestorians and Jacobites, who mutated Jesus into a trinity, deified. Jews still boast that they killed a false prophet and ridicule Jesus as being an illegitimate Sabbath-breaking magician, whereas Christians idolize him as the actual Son of God, whose resurrection cancels their sins by Pauline superstition. The Bible says hypocrite Jews once asked Jesus what his major sign would be, yet his other miracles they ridiculed. So he said it would be as the sign of Jonah, who seemingly died swallowed by a whale, but all who witnessed it were fooled. In reality, Allah kept Jonah, or Yunus, alive for days in the belly of the fish before it disgorged him on land to revival. And so with Jesus, whose earthly disappearance will seem like a few days from his perspective before his re-arrival. And just like Jonah, who left Nineveh whilst only a few believed, over 100,000 flocked to him when he came back, fearing Allah would punish them for rejecting Jonah. In his absence, they made repentance as their piety was slack. However outlandish it seems, Einstein's relativity suggests time speeds up for a traveler nearing the speed of light, so a few days of space travel at angelic speeds, while many centuries pass by on Earth, is possible with Allah's might. For in the not-too-distant future, Jesus will return to Earth, still aged 33. Just as he went up, so shall he come down, with a medium build, a red-white Syrian skin tone, straight shoulder-length hair, wearing a saffron thobe and gown. Since the dawn of man, there hasn't been such a tribulation as that of the Antichrist Dajjal, about to be released. Deceived ones will take him as the Jewish Moshiach, Christian Christ, or Shia, hidden Imam, and Armageddon will be unleashed. In famine, he'll bring food and treasures, bring visions of heaven and sensual pleasures, and resurrect the dead using jinn, claiming divinity, He'll even be a trial for believers, so much so that one's family will be tied indoors to avoid his sin. It is your duty to equip yourself with knowledge about Dajjal, may he be cursed, and how to combat his deception. He is so insignificant in honor that he isn't worthy of mention in the Quran, but his evil rule will end in humiliation. The first mission Jesus will carry out is to hunt down and kill the Antichrist imposter, or Dajjal, the liar with one eye. After descending to earth near a white minaret in Syria's East Damascus on the wings of two angels from the sky. Descending near what is now called the Jesus Bride Minaret, beads of perspiration will fall as Jesus lowers his head, and when he raises it, beads like pearls will scatter, killing all disbelievers within his sight who smell his odor dead. In Syria's Umayyad or Umayyad Mosque, Muslims along with Caliph Imam Mahdi by Dajjal's army will be surrounded, but after the Iqama or call to prayer has been sounded for Fajr or dawn prayer, all will look up to the sky astounded. After landing, Jesus will pray behind Imam Mahdi as a final gesture before taking over the Muslim command chain. That will be a great day, when the bloodline of Abraham's sons Ishmael and Isaac unify under Jesus or Isa's reign. Imam Mahdi will step backwards, but Jesus will place his hand on his shoulder and tell him to lead the congregation, politely saying, "No, for some are elevated over others as an honor from Allah to this Ummah or Islamic nation." Dajjal will flee towards Elia or Jerusalem as Jesus pursues towards Muslims already besieged on a mountainous region. As Mujahideen there line up in rows for the Subh or morning prayer, they'll be ecstatic to see Jesus join their legion. Jesus will lead them in Subh prayer, and rising from Ruku to Sami Allahu liman hamida, he will include the invocation, "May Allah kill Masih ad-Dajjal and make Muslims succeed." After prayer, he'll ask for the doors to be open in anticipation. Jesus will chase him and find him near Bab al-Lud, or the Gate of Lidda, close to Ramallah, near Jerusalem's airport. Dajjal may eventually die disintegrated close to Aqaba Afiq, near Syria's Golan Heights, according to a reliable report. For Jesus will strike him with a spear, and Dajjal will start melting as salt dissolves, his blood on the spearhead's top. Dajjal's army, including Mongols, Bedouins, and 70,000 sword-wielding Jews will scatter, and his evil deception will stop. At that time, Jesus will command the Muslims to fight Dajjal's army and exterminate any of his followers they meet. Even a rock or tree, except the boxthorn tree they hide behind, will speak and expose them to be killed in defeat. Whilst Jesus is wiping the faces of believers, telling them of their heavenly ranks, Allah will ask him to take flight and seek refuge on Mount Tur or Sinai against the hordes of Gog and Magog, against whom none will be able to fight. For so many of them will escape from Dhul Qurnayn's wall that they'll drink the Sea of Galilee dry to get their fill, swarming down from every hilltop. Except for ones who fortify themselves in cities, they'll pillage, destroy, and kill. Then on Mount Hamar of Bayt al-Maqdis, possibly the Olivet Hill of Corruption, Gog and Magog in defiance will cry, "We've killed those upon earth, now let us kill those in the sky," and launch arrows that'll return bloody from the sky. As for what Gog and Magog attack, whether men in planes or space stations or flying jinn UFOs, only Allah knows best. But after every hardship, Allah sends ease, and the remembrance of Allah will provide nourishment during this test. At that time, Jesus and the believers with him will be so hard-pressed that even an ox head will be a valued prize. In desperation, Jesus will supplicate to Allah, who will send neck-burrowing insects, causing Gog and Magog's demise. The hordes will all die as a single person, and most of Earth's span will fill with their putrefied stench which reeks. Jesus will implore Allah again, who'll send birds with camel-like necks to dispose of the corpses by talons and beaks. People will start emerging from fortified cities, and their flocks will get fat, eating Gog and Magog's corpse remains. Gog and Magog's bows and arrows will be used for fuel for 7 years thereafter, as technology will no longer be urbane. Then, Allah will send a rain, which will even pass through brick walls, cleansing earth till it looks like a shiny silver tray. The earth will then be restored to its full blessings and capability and grow huge fruits as in the era of Adam's day. As a side point, one of the biggest lies spread is that man evolved from apes, whereas we came from Adam, a giant. He was 60 cubits tall, and we've been shrinking ever since, as have fruits and animals, to which true science is compliant. Under Jesus' blessed reign, a pomegranate will grow so huge that a group of men could find shelter under its skin. Milk yields will increase, a cow would provide milk for a whole tribe, and once emaciated animals will no longer be thin. A bull will be worth more than a horse, for all wars will cease, and people will turn to farming and plow the fields. Swords will be turned into sickles. Even a seed thrown on a barren mountain like Al-Safa will sprout vegetation yields. Peace will abound, and jealousy, hatred, and spite will disappear. Even the poisonous sting of insects will be detached. A baby would put his hand into a snake's mouth and not be harmed, and run with a lion as if playing a game of catch. Lions will graze with camels, leopards mingle with cows, and wolves will be like sheepdogs to sheep, sharing dominance. Jesus will destroy all crosses, kill all swine, abolish jizya tax on Jews and Christians, and rely on Allah's providence. Jesus will not abrogate any part of Islam except jizya tax, which currently ensures protections of Christians and Jews. But in his era, he'll unite the world in the worship of Allah. So either conversion to Islam or war will all have to choose. Jesus will be a just judge, ruling with the Quran and Sunnah, unifying the world as a righteous leader of one nation. Charity will no longer be accepted, as people realize that better than wealth is to worship Allah by a single prostration. From Al-Rawaha near Medina, Jesus will don ihram pilgrim garments, and Umrah or Hajj to Mecca he will perform. The earth will be full of peace, as a pot full of water. Qurayshi rule will end, and unity under Islam will be the norm. Due to Dajjal, Armageddon's wars, and Gog and Magog's devastation, people will be desperate to see an end to harm. With a ratio of 50 women to one man, everyone will humbly bow to Allah with full conviction in the benefits of Islam. Jesus will live for 40 years, get married, and have children, as the final chapters of his miraculous life are unfurled. But people will shun materialism, for they will know that Jesus' arrival marks the countdown to the end of the world. Imam Mahdi will die before him, but Jesus' own grave is already allotted. When he dies, the whole world will mourn. Jesus will be buried next to Muhammad, peace be upon him, in Medina, raised up together on the last day by angel Israfil's horn. Jesus will have died before seeing the destruction of the Kaaba by the Ethiopian the Aswaykatain to steal its wealth. When the Hajj is discontinued, all traces of the Quran will vanish, and the world will be ready to end in abrupt stealth. Soon afterwards, a cool wind from Syria will blow, taking the believers' souls, even those with the faith of a tiny grain. This zephyr will reach them, even if they were hidden under a mountain, leaving behind only the evil in utter disdain. The earth will then contain only the wicked and impious, bird-brained without intellect and aggressive like beasts, unable to enjoin goodness or condemn evil, yet even such dire circumstances will not deter Satan's goal in the least. For upon this wicked generation who fornicate in public like asses, Satan will revive idol worship in earth's last days. But his last stand will be insignificant, for soon after, angel Israfil will blow the trumpet signaling judgment day. All praise is due to Allah, that his final revelation, the Quran and Sunnah, is preserved as a guide till earth's ending. The Prophet, peace be upon him, requested for us to relay his greetings or salams to Jesus when he returns, and his arrival is pending. Jesus will recognize Muslims as his true inheritors. Yet the Zionist-controlled media has poisoned your perceptions. But this is to be expected, for Allah guides those whom He loves, whilst conceited ones will follow the Dajjal's deceptions. If you've been programmed to dismiss Islam as false, time is running out for you to learn about it with an open heart. The Quran and Sunnah is future-proof, for Jesus will rule the world with its rulings. So why don't you get a head start?
اتل ما أوحي إليك من الكتاب وأقم الصلاة إن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون.
وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُوا الزَّكَاةَ وَارْكَعُوا مَعَ الرَّاكِعِينَ. وَإِذْ صَرَفْنَا إِلَيْكَ نَفَرًا مِنَ الْجِنِّ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقُرْآنَ فَلَمَّا حَضَرُوهُ قَالُوا أَنصِتُوا فَلَمَّا قُضِيَ وَلَّوْا إِلَى قَوْمِهِم مُنذِرِينَ.
هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو عالم الغيب والشهادة هو الرحمن الرحيم هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار المتكبر سبحان الله عما يشركون هو الله الخالق البارئ المصور له الأسماء الحسنى يسبح له ما في السماوات والأرض وهو العزيز الحكيم
وإذ قلنا للملائكة اسجدوا لآدم فسجدوا إلا إبليس قال أأسجد لمن خلقت طينا قال أرأيتك هذا الذي كرمت علي لئن أخرتني إلى يوم القيامة لأحتنكن ذريته إلا قليلا قال اذهب فمن تبعك منهم فإن جهنم جزاؤكم جزاء موفورا واستفزز من استطعت منهم بصوتك وأجلب عليهم بخيلك ورجلك وشاركهم في الأموال والأولاد وعدهم وما يعدهم الشيطان إلا غرورا إن عبادي ليس لك عليهم سلطان وكفى بربك وكيلا
أولم ير الذين كفروا أن السماوات والأرض كانتا رتقا ففتقناهما وجعلنا من الماء كل شيء حي أفلا يؤمنون قل أئنكم لتكفرون بالذي خلق الأرض في يومين وتجعلون له أندادا ذلك رب العالمين وجعل فيها رواسي من فوقها وبارك فيها وقدر فيها أقواتها في أربعة أيام سواء للسائلين ثم استوى إلى السماء وهي دخان فقال لها وللأرض ائتيا طوعا أو كرها قالتا أتينا طائعين فقضاهن سبع سماوات في يومين وأوحى في كل سماء أمرها وزينا السماء الدنيا بمصابيح وحفظا ذلك تقدير العزيز العليم وما قدر الله حق قدره والأرض جميعا قبضته يوم القيامة والسماوات مطويات بيمينه سبحانه وتعالى عما يشركون.
Under the scorching sun on the plains of Arafat, Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم delivered his final sermon. O people, listen to my words carefully, for I know not whether after this year I shall ever meet you again at this place. O people, your lives and your property are sacrosanct until you meet your Lord, as are this holy place, this holy day, and this holy month. Remember that you will indeed meet your Lord and answer for your deeds. So beware. Whoever of you is holding a trust, let him return it to its rightful owner. All usury is abolished. Your capital, however, is yours to keep. Wrong not, and you shall not be wronged. All bloodshed from the pagan age of ignorance is to be left unavenged. O people, the devil has lost all hope of ever being worshipped in this land of yours. Nevertheless, he will try to mislead you in smaller matters. Beware of him, therefore, for the safety of your religion. Time has turned, and it is as it was the day that God created the heavens and the earth. The number of months is 12. 4 of them are holy, in which war and fighting are forbidden. O man, you have your rights over your wives, and they have rights over you, and chastise them without cruelty. But if they abide by your rights, then they have the right to be fed and clothed in kindness. Do treat your women well, and be kind to them, for they are your partners and committed helpers. You have taken them only as a trust from Allah, and you have their enjoyment only by His permission. So listen to me in earnest, O people, and reason well. I leave behind me two things, the Quran and my example. If you follow them, you will not go astray. O people, listen to my words. Know that every Muslim is a brother to every Muslim, and that all Muslims constitute one brotherhood. It is only lawful to take from a brother what he gives you willingly, so wrong not yourselves. The Prophet ﷺ then faced the heavens and said, Be my witness, O Allah, that I have conveyed your message to your people. It was then that some of the final words of the Quran were revealed.
اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا
This day I have perfected your religion for you and have completed my favor upon you and have chosen for you as religion, al-Islam.
if we're given the proper knowledge and the proper understanding and given the proper instruction, we should begin to see measurable feedback in our life. If you make the effort to sit down and design a new life and you make it the most important thing, and you spend time every day feeding it like a gardener feeds a seed, you will produce fruit.
Ya Rabbi, afwan in asa'tu fa innani abdun da'ifun ya ilahi fani wa la in asabtu fa minka wahdaka khaliqi anta al-karim wa wasi'ul ghufrani.